Okay, so I have now actually more than 1,000 hours in Hunt Showdown, and I wanted to put together this general purpose trait priority list for the hunters. So this is the order of priority that I pick the traits for basically all my hunters, and this is for general purpose hunters, and then I have the tools and consumables that you see in the upper right corner there. When I recruit my first hunter, I try to look for the doctor symbol. I take the doctor as the first trait, and then I try to go for physician because healing quickly and fully is the most important trait that you can have in this game, I would say. So if I recruit an expensive hunter that has doctor and two other small traits that I'm not interested in, then I use blood bonds and change these two traits, for example, 2 plus 3 point trait points to get physician. So this is basically the starting point for for all my hunters, doctor and physician. And this helps you in basically all engagement, all firefights. The next two slots, I pick traits that are specific for the loadout that you have. So this can be, for example, bullet grabber and fanning, if you have, for example, a long ammo gun and a random pistol. That means that you don't lose a bullet when you reload your long ammo gun, and fanning, you can then use a pistol close quarters. So this is very strong and will help you to win many firefights. If I have a Winnie, I would take levering and iron repeater. Levering makes the Winnie really, really strong close quarters gun, even mid-range, and iron repeater makes it pretty good on range. You can stay in scope with the Winnies, keep ADSing for that mid-range headshot engagements. Quartermaster is very strong, one of the strongest traits in the game, I think, and you can make quite many interesting loadouts with Quartermaster. For example, you can use dual wielding. So let's say that you have a long ammo gun on the primary slot, and then you can have a medium slot with two pistols and use dual wielding. And then you can take these ambidextrous traits to reload them quickly. You should try the dual packs with dual wielding. That's really, really strong close to mid-range. Quartermaster can be used in many other ways. If you have a crossbow, for example, you can have this bolt thrower to reload the crossbow quickly. So you can have a fully sized crossbow and, for example, Ober's Mace in the medium slot. Then you have a very strong loadout. Or you can have a fully sized gun and then a hand crossbow in the medium slot. You can experiment with Quartermaster in very many ways, and it's probably one of the strongest traits in the game, I would say. You can have, for example, a fully sized shotgun and then an Ober's Mace, and that's a very, very strong loadout. You can also, of course, maximize your lebel or Mosin by having bullet grabber and iron sharpshooter. I basically never play sniper, but if you do, you can have these two slots with the sniper traits, like the steady aim and a sniper scope smith or whatever it's called, where you can remain in scope with the sniper gun. So that would specialize your loadout for the sniper. Okay, so after these two traits, I would go for mobility traits. Determination and Greyhound. I typically pick Determination before Greyhound because stamina is slightly important, more important than being able to run for a longer time. Sheep traits, 7 points, you can get these both at the same time. After that, I pick Necromancer. Necromancer is new since the 1.4.8 patch or something like that. And it's really changed the game a lot, I think. And it's very strong that you can revive your partner in a 25 meter distance. Pick this one if you want to be flexible when it comes to reviving your teammates. And I mean, especially if you play with hunters, players that are better than you, then you, this is even more important that you are able to pick them up to help you to win the fight. After that, if I have six more trade points, I would take Pack Mule and Mithraist. Pack Mule is really good because you get two instead of one. Consumables, for example, when you loot, so you can replenish after you have succeeded if you wipe the team and you're out of consumables, then you can quickly replenish using this pack mule. Mithridist reduce the impact of hives. We can also save you in firefights as well. So after that, depending on how many trade points I would pick, if I have 8 trade points, I would pick Frontiersman. If I have 5, I would pick Lightfoot. Frontiersman is expensive trait, but it's good because you get one more first aid kit and one more choke bomb, which can help you to survive a firefight. Lightfoot is really, really strong in the right hands, I would say. You have to learn how to use it. You can jump 3 times without making any sound, and then crouch, wait for a while, and then jump 3 more times. And you can flank players, even if you are close to them, without making any sound. So if you have seen the pro players on YouTube, they use this all the time. But I think it's a little bit difficult to use, but when you learn to use it, it's very, very strong. All right, so after this, I would pick Serpent. Serpent means that you can slurp the bounty before they banish it. And if you manage to do that, you can make a quick scan, see where everybody, all of the enemies are, and then engage. So this can actually help you in a firefight as well. After that, I would pick Beastface. Flanking is very, very important in Hunt and also in basically all first-person shooter games, and flanking without getting noticed is very strong and makes you win many engagement. Last two slots is not so important. I think I have already my favorite traits now, but for the last two, I would pick, for example, Silent Killer, not for killing grunts silently, but for you can charge your knife or your bomb lance or your saber if you have a knife on whatever it's called, if you have your knife on the on your Mosin, then you can charge it silently. And if you are close to people in compounds, knife, bomb lance, saber, and all these melee weapons are very, very strong. And if you can charge it silently, it increases your probability of winning that fight. Last slot, I would maybe pick Bulwark. Bulwark saved me 2, 3, 4 times in my 1,000 hours, maybe. Once I was actually hit by a bomb lance shot, and I survived it because of Bulwark. Otherwise, you die instantly from a bomb lance. So, last slot, you can of course pick something else. For example, Whispersmith, you can change between your slots silently. This one decreases your fall damage with 50%, and it actually helped me to survive 2 or 3 times in my 1,000 hours, I would guess. Resilience is also good. If you get revived, then you can engage and help your partner directly without starting to heal the first thing you do. So this saved me 2 or 3 times as well in my 1,000 hours. Many people like Gator Legs. I'm not so fond of it actually, because it doesn't help you in actual engagement. I mean, water you should actually try to stay away from water, go around it. And not because of speed, but because of sound. If you run through water with or without gator legs, people hear you from like 100 meters away. So I typically do not pick gator legs, even though people seem to like it a lot. Of course, you can also in these last two slots pick goal. Goal is expensive, it's 7 trade points, and it doesn't really help you in actual engagement. I mean, after an engagement it can help you, but then again, after an engagement you can find health kits in compounds and so on. So this is the trade list, this is the order of priority in which I pick the traits for basically all my hunters. So I hope that this helped. Maybe if some of you are new to the game, you can look at this and get some tips on how you choose your traits. All right, thank you.